Hello everyone, today we will look at the details of working with our MS112 test bench for diagnostics of electric compressors of automotive air conditioners. As you know, electric cars has a differences in decision and construction, and presence of an electric compressor is one of them. In some cars, broken electric compressors causes the air conditioning system to fall and additionally the main battery to cool. The MS112 test bench makes it easy to diagnose and to locate faults and verify full operation capability after restoration. Our experience has shown that this test bench greatly simplifies the work of the mechanics and car service centers, as there is no need to install and remove the compressor once again. But let's look at the sequence and details of working with the test bench and diagnosing electric compressors. Vadim, who developed this equipment, will tell us about it.
Hello everyone! I would like to say that we have already developed a consistent operating scheme that allows us to clearly identify operable compressors, those that can still be restored, and those that have already worked.
First of all, we conduct a quick test on the test bench. During this test, we do not use nitrogen, but simply connect the compressor to the bench with cables. In the unit selection menu, the bench will tell you which cables to use.
Express test allows you to test the compressor without nitrogen. You can check whether it is capable of pumping something and whether it makes sense to do full inspection or whether it needs to be repaired and disassembled.
Connect the high voltage cable and data cable. We fasten the unit with the belt that does not leave scratch, but hold the compressor firmly. In this case, we do not install fittings. Run the express test. By pinching the outlet port with your finger, you can feel whether the compressor is generating pressure. This procedure allows you to quickly sort out obviously faulty compressors if no pressure is felt. To determine the remaining service life of the compressor, we perform an internal inspection on the scroll rotor parts. Check the spiral rotor for wear and tear. For testing on the bench, it is sometimes necessary to use special oil in amount of more than 30 grams. And after the test, we draw the working oil and fill in the native oil. It's worth nothing that we teach how to work with the test bench and diagnose electric compressors. So, we will tell you in detail about how the compressor is created, what task it performs, and how to detect it fix malfunction.
The compressor must be tested under load on a bench. Only then you can be sure that both the mechanical and electrical parts of the compressor are working properly.
To start a full diagnosis, we connect a source of compressed nitrogen to the bench. It is very important that the nitrogen connection pipes are free from depressors, as they impede the flows of gas. We connect nitrogen to the test bench. Connect the nitrogen cylinder to the test bench with hoses. Make sure that the disassembly to the stand is between 7 or 8 bar. Install the unit on the test bench. And here, pay attention. Attach the fittings to the compressor and only then connect the quick connectors. The test bench will tell you which fittings you need to use. Select the required model in the test bench database. We attach the unit to the test bench. We also need two cables, a high voltage cable and data cable. Connect the cables to the test bench. The cables are individually matched to the machine model and car also be found in the database. We already have more than 15 information cables and almost 20 high voltage cables. The unit is connected. We spent a full test. Thank you. The indicators immediately show the green inspection online means that test bench has established communication with the compressor inverter. Here we can see the diagnostic data sent to us by the compressor, namely the voltage and rotor speed. If the test bench is unable to communicate with the inverter, you may have used the wrong cable or a faulty compressor inverter. As you can see, we have a functional unit. It delivers normal pressure and all components are in good working order.
Let's say right away that our most common reasons for interrupting the test. This always indicates a malfunction in the unit.
Short circuit. The compressors did not start. Either the compressor rotor is jammed or the electrical part is defective. The compressor stopped on its own during the test, before it was completed. This may indicate a malfunction of the electrical part.
We check the compressor at the test bench, which we repaired, and make sure that all components of compressor is working properly. Now we can give it to the customer or install in a car.
As you can see, working with a test bench is very simple. It doesn't take up much space, but it does require some knowledge and proper connection. It is worth nothing that it has a function of protection against incorrect user behavior. So, with our instruction and the help with the test bench, you can quickly master the operation of the machine. And if you want to get more information, our specialist will tell you everything in detail and show you everything. We will leave contact information in the description. Each of our clients receive technical support from the company, and our masters are always ready to provide advice and answer the question. And yes, we provide a warranty for our equipment for up to 2 years. Do not forget. Thank you for watching. I hope it is useful. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel and our social media channels, where we always announce new updates. See you soon on air.